Hello everybody and welcome to Web Applications for Everybody. We are on Windows 10 and we're going to do something a little crazy. We are going to try to make it so that you can run PHP, MySQL, and everything on Windows. And it all starts with the bash shell. So if you're Googling and try to figure out how this works, always look for the word bash on Windows. This is a new feature that's part of Windows 10. You might need to upgrade your Windows 10. You got to go here into turning Windows features on and off. And you scroll down and look at that. Windows subsystem for Linux beta. Usually we call this the bash shell because it gives us a Unix user interface. So I'm going to install this, okay? And it's going to take a little bit. So I'm going to have to restart, so I will come back and I will pick back up with this after the restart. Okay, so welcome back. We are now going to run this for the first time. Okay, I just rebooted and installed it. It was a pretty quick reboot. I'm going to type bash. See the bash, the run command? That is what I'm going to do, bash enter. So here's the thing. There's going to be some stuff that it's going to do, and it's going to do a secondary installation the first time you run it, and this is actually going to be the longer installation. So I'm saying yes, away I go. Okay, so it's going to download a whole bunch of stuff. So now what it's doing is it's creating a file system. In effect, this is a guest operating system, and so it's going to create a Unix inside of Windows. Okay, so now this is complete. This is really an operating system, and so we're going to create a Unix username, and I'm going to make mine the same as my Windows username, and it's the same as I use on my Macintosh as well. Actually, I'm going to make it be CSEV. Dr. Chuck is actually my name on Windows. So now I have to put in a password. Now remember that. So now the installation is complete. And what we need to do is we need to find our home directory in this new system. So I'm going to just type the CD command here. And CD in Linux goes to your home directory. And PWD shows your current home directory. And so within the Linux world, or the bash shell, I am in home/CSIP. Now, it would be helpful for us to find this in our Windows world. It is kind of tricky. Okay, so I'm going to find you in the Windows world. I'm going to start on my C drive. So Windows is trying to be too helpful. Go into Users. Then I'm going to Dr. Chuck. Okay, and there is a folder in here called App Data that I can't see because it's hidden. You can unhide it, or you can just cheat here and say /appdata. That's fine. /local/lxss/home/ and then my Linux account, CSEV. And so what happens now is I am now in a folder in Windows. This is Windows, and I am in this folder. So if I create a file, I'll just touch a file. There's a touch command to create an empty file, abc123. I'll say touch abc123. And if I do an ls, I'll see that. And now I should see that same file over here. So I've made that. Now I can do the same thing using Atom. I can get Atom, and I've already got it here. Atom can find its way down into this folder. Now, do not mess with any of these other folders other than your home folder, or you will be in like severe trouble. But here's like abc123, and right now I'm going to edit it. It's a new file. Hello there from Atom. I'm going to save it. And now if I come down here and I do an ls, and I do a cat of abc123, which is concatenate, you see that I am editing a file inside my bash shell. So you can kind of get to this and maybe make a shortcut to it. Or maybe I can make a shortcut to my, go back. Can I make a shortcut to this somehow? If I go to this, can I make a shortcut to this? Let's see if I can put a shortcut to this. Into pin to quick access. Let's see if that helps me. Where is quick access? Look at that. I just pinned it to quick access. So I'm going to go right here. Click. Look at that. I've got it pinned to quick access. I got in there and I came up here and I say pin to quick access. Now I don't know if, let me see if I can make this atom nicely open to the right place by just grabbing this little folder and dragging it into atom. Oh, well, I wanted to drag it into atom. And then it'll open it. So there we go. Oh, I can't even type right. Okay, so there we go. We're using Atom on our Windows box to talk to our home directory in Linux. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do is we are going to clears your screen. Is I'm going to type a command that is going to install the Apache web server and a whole bunch of stuff. This is apt is a package manager. And so now we're loading all of these. It's downloading these things and then it'll install them all. So I need to make a password for my root user. For now, I'm just going to call it root. This is not the most secure situation. I'm just doing this for my own desktop stuff. You may want to have a better one. Arrow down, hit OK. So it's downloading and building and compiling and doing a lot of stuff. We'd never be able to figure all this stuff out ourselves. Okay, so let's start Apache. So we're going to type sudo, and that's because we're connecting to port 80, etc init dot d apache 2 start. Got to type your password. And now we have an Apache web server running on the Linux side of this world inside our, and if I go to localhost, and make sure you don't have XAMPP or anything else running on your Windows side, because you can only have one thing talking, and so that is the web page. Now let me show you where that web page is at on the Linux side. Oops, hide. Okay, so you go into cd /var /www.html ls-l. There's index.html. Now I'm going to edit a little file. I'm going to use a thing called Vim, which is my text editor. I'm going to call test.htm, and I'm going to hit the I to go in insert mode. You can learn Vim some other time. H1 hello world /h1. And I'm going to hit escape, :wq. Yep, that's how you get out. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. I couldn't, :wq. It says I can't open the file for writing, so I have to be root. So let me, :q, !! I need to be root. And so one of the ways to become root is do this, sudo sh. So that starts a new, let's say bash, not Nash and Nash equilibrium. Sudo bash, and now I am in here, and this pound sign says I'm the root user. And now I can do a vi of test.html, test.htmm. I did an insert, h1, hello world, slash h1, escape, colon, wq, escape gets me out of insert mode. And now if I do an ls, I see index.htm and test.htm. And so if I say test.htm, hello world. So this is Internet Explorer on my Windows side that's talking to the Apache server in my Linux side. Okay, so all kinds of things that you can do there. So now let's do some other stuff. Let's talk to the database server. MySQL minus u root minus p. And root is the password. Oh. Now I need to start the MySQL server. etc init.d MySQL start. I forgot to start it. So up comes the MySQL server. So I think it's okay. So now I should be able to type MySQL minus u root minus p. So that was the SQL server. Now I'm starting the SQL client, root, and there I go, show databases. And I can say create database MISC. Use MISC. Show databases. There you go. And then to get out of this, you just type Control D. So now you have MySQL running. You have Apache running. Now just we need to shut them down. So I'm going to shut them down. etc init.d Apache 2 stop and etc init d MySQL stop. So now I've shut down my servers. Okay, now those messages aren't a problem. I'm going to escape out of the sudo shell, say exit. And now I'm going to get out of the shell completely within our control D. And now I am out of this. And so that finishes our little welcome to web applications for everybody. It takes a little bit of skill and you'll have to learn a little Linux, but you can get started and do the homework assignments on Linux, of all things Linux within Windows. And so I tend to do things like bash Windows 10. That's the kind of stuff, you know, how to install Apache. And so I do looks like things like that. And so there's someone else's how you do this. So bash on Windows 10 is a good thing to prefix your searches to try to figure this out. And it's still emerging. You might think it's crude, but it is amazingly impressive. And it is quite amazing what Microsoft has done to make what I just show you work. So it's super impressive. Hope this has been useful.